And then the puck is steered into the corner. A centering pass right in front. Palat turned and missed the net. What a chance for Andre Palat. Here's Ryan McDonagh back to the front of the net. Quick shot, score! Kucherov gets the goal with 8 seconds to go. And the Lightning will go up 2-0 in the series.
You've got an absolutely stunned New York Islander bench. The look on Varlamov's face says it all. Three great chances by the Tampa Bay Lightning. It started with Gord, the backhand, but the key here is they kept the play alive, kept it down low, kept the New York Islanders with a mishmash of a line. You got Andrew Ladd there in front, can't get his man. Palat had a great chance, just missed to the outside. A bouncing puck that Green can't control. A good pinch in from the corner, and how about that pass by Ryan McDonagh? Right through the seam. Nobody able to take the most dangerous man left in the lineup, and Kucherov. Look at that reaction. You don't think he realizes what not having to go to overtime does for a depleted bench. What a goal.
19:52. Vasilevsky shows his excitement. Nikita Kucherov, sixth of the playoffs. Here comes Everly back the other way. Couldn't get a good shot away. The seconds tick down. The Islanders are going to run out of time. Lightning strikes with 8 seconds to go. And Tampa Bay has a 2-0 series lead.
Lewis goal, 5 seconds. Worked back out to the point from the car. Down to the circle. McKinnon across from Landeskog. Rebound, score!
That looked like to me that the puck had crossed the line before we hit zeros. The puck hits the post. There, and then there. Kadri, who had a great chance right before that. Couldn't believe he missed it. He's got an empty net with time expiring. Does this puck cross the goal line before zeros on the board? That's the question.
Wow, how close is that?
Oh man, that is right on the line.
It's tight.
Gotta be completely over the line. There's the puck. One. Looks like a good goal there. At point one, it looks like it's over. Right there. Now, is that puck completely over? That camera is not directly over the goal line. It's off center a little bit. So again, the league is looking at a bunch of different looks.
Upon review, we have a goal on the ice. We need the clock reset to point one.
It is a goal.
And Thomas Plekanec skates out to center. His pass for Pacioretty. Knocked down. Under 10 seconds to go. But here they come again. Andre Palat holds up. Victor Hedman walks in. Passes. Johnson scores! Tyler Johnson. With no time on the clock. They'll have to review to make sure, but it looked like the puck was in before the green light came on and there was time.
And there's no question about this. As the puck goes right five hole on Carey Price off the stick, not the skate of Johnson, 0.7 about when that puck went in. But on a night when it looked like Tampa was never going to score again, it's an errant dump in at the end. Strowman with a heads-up play, a good outlet pass. Palat with an area pass to Hedman coming through, and in desperation, Markov down and out, Subban a little late, and Johnson with his stick on the ice. It's in.
And the roof's about to come off.
1.1 second left, so therefore...
Nothing in this series, and what a heartbreaker for the Montreal Canadiens when a goal is scored and you don't even get a face-off with a chance to come back.
Tampa Bay Lightning celebrate Tyler Johnson and Ben Bishop deliver them to victory, and the crowd ecstatic here at the Amalie Arena.
Woodrow, maybe one last chance. Centers scores!
Chris, I've talked about matchups so often, and you've got the right four people out on the ice. There's the clock above. No question that this one's going to count. Sherratt and Weber on the back end. You've got Deneau in a position with Staal and Toffoli, but this is something you just can't happen. How about the effort, though, of Coleman? Just gives his body up. Make sure. Watch his hands. All he's concerned about is swinging on that one. You've got a defender in Deneau trying to come back and knock it to the left. Coleman gets enough of it to get it back towards the net, and it goes underneath the blocker of Price. What a momentum swing that one is, and Brisebois knows it. 0.3 seconds makes it a 2-1 lead going to the third period.
McDavid waiting, centering. No, it went off the shaft because of a stick that threw it in front, and at the buzzer, Leon Draisaitl puts Edmonton on top, 4-3. The Oilers are going to win this hockey game.
Wow, talk about a buzzer beater at the last second. That is staying with it. McDavid fumbles the puck a bit, but he stays on it. And Puljujärvi in front of the net as well. He eventually is able to work this puck right out to Draisaitl. They're going to take a look at this to see if it was in time. I believe it was, though, Jack. You nailed it. But just an excellent job by McDavid to stay with it. Good job here by Beaulieu. Disrupts it a bit, but right there, that pass out to Draisaitl. It is off the stick in an absolute split second, and he beats Brisebois. Watch this on the clock, lower right. And it's in the net before it runs out of time. What a buzzer beater by Leon Draisaitl to win this game with fractions of...
Just missed. 5 seconds, 2-on-1. Favre with Larkin down to 3. Here comes Larkin moving in on Johansson. He scores! Just beats the buzzer. With 0.2 seconds remaining in the period.
And then off to the races, Robbie Fabry and Dylan Larkin. We talked about look out for Larkin with all this open ice. Well, there's the open ice, and he just hammers it home on the back end. The Detroit Red Wing bench screaming and yelling, time on the clock. Well, they realize it, and Larkin, what a finish. He's coming as advertised tonight, isn't he, Kenny?
He sure is.